morning, dear students, and welcome back to our chapter first of political science on equality. In the last session class, we read about three person or three stories who were treated unequally on the basis of their social class, on the basis of their riches or poor. Second, it was Ansaris who were treated unequally or who were discriminated on the basis of their religion, and the third person, Om Prakash Valmiki, who was discriminated on the basis of his caste as he belonged to a Dalit family. So class, today we are going to study about the discrimination or unequal treatment to the Indians or to the citizen of a country, and along with that we will cover the topics factors which factors of discrimination. Second, universal adult franchising. Third, right to equality. Fourth, role of government to implement equality. Fifth, Article 15, and the last topic, civil rights movement. Okay, class, one by one we are going to study. As we first cover the topic which we are going to cover is factors of discrimination. The factors on which people discriminate or people do partiality with others. वो दूसरों में या एक citizen दूसरे citizen में फर्क कैसे करता है या फिर अंतर कैसे करता है. The first factor which describes the discrimination is caste. Some belong to the higher caste like Pandits or Kshatriya, and some may be of lower caste like Dalits. Second, religion. Many people in India are discriminated on the basis of religion, like Hindu and Muslims. Suppose there is a community, Hindu community living in an area, and suppose a Muslim family wants to live there or wants to buy a land. Many people, the Hindu community may discriminate. You are a Muslim, you are not allowed to live here. But the religion may be a factor of discrimination. Next, gender. Many times we Indians or some people or some citizen differentiate between the gender, male and female. Suppose many people say women should not fly aeroplanes or they should not be a pilot. Means pilot course is not meant for women. They should do household chores or household works. So this is discrimination. Such kind of things leads to the discrimination. On the basis of gender, we do discriminate. Like we always say that boy should not cry. Crying is meant for girls only. This is a discrimination. Second, color. We do discriminate on the basis of color. Right? If we talk about America, America is a country in ancient time or in 50s to 60s, there used to be discrimination between the blacks and the whites. I mean, gore aur kaale mein bhi fark hota tha wahan pe. Theek hai? Then social status. Social status means someone is working as the owner of a company or managing director of the company, and the other one is working as the just as the worker in the company or some menial job in the company. So there people may discriminate. He is the MD, he must be treated with some he should be treated like fairly or nicely, and the person who works or who do menial job in the factory, he is considered, oh, he is just a this and this, he should not be treated with such high fair or dignity. Next, education. We citizens also differentiate people on the basis of education. Someone who is highly educated is respected, and someone who is not educated is discriminated, or he is said to be that you are not worthy of respect or dignity. So these are the factors which affects the discrimination, or which are the root causes of discrimination. Now we are going to discuss the second topic, that is universal adult franchising. Universal adult franchising, that means a country which is republic. 18 years or certain years of age. In India, it is 18 years. In India, all the citizens who are above 18 years have the right to cast their vote. And by casting their vote, they can elect the head of the state. Head of the state. State here doesn't mean the state like Uttarakhand or Uttar Pradesh. State here means the nation. Okay? Nation. State here means the nation. Okay, class, I have written a word republic over here. Let's say republic. Republic. Republic, basically in Hindi, it means Ganatantra. Gan means the people and the Tantra means the system. So, republic means a system where the head of the state is elected by the ordinary citizens or the citizens of the country, and where people elect their own head of the country. Let's say in easier words, let's understand it as by the people. By the people means the head of the state. Jo kisi desh ka head hota hai. Suppose it be the president or the prime minister. In India, the head of the country is the prime minister. And if we talk about America, US, there the head of the nation or state is president. So, a republic country is a country where the citizen of India, the head of the state is elected by the people. For the people, and the elected head has to do the good and development of the people, for the people, who is elected for the people, who represents the people over there. Means whatever our demands be. Suppose I want a sewage, proper sewage system or drainage system in my area. So, the head of the state, that means the prime minister or local government, will do the things for people like me who demand or who want development in the area and to the people. And the head of the state will be committed to the people. And the first thing the head of the nation or state will do is all the things who will do the welfare of the people of his state or country. So, this is the meaning of republic. By the people, the head of the department or head of the nation or state is elected by the people, for the people, whose work is to do the good of the people, who will be standing there as a representative, MLA or MP, for the people, who would represent for the people and who do the welfare and development of the people. Is that clear, class? Let's move further. So, it was, we were discussing universal adult franchisee. Universal adult franchisee, I have explained that all the people of India or all the people of a country above some certain age have the right to cast their vote and elect the head of the state. Then, let's discuss the right to equality. Beyond this, universal adult franchisee, our government, the government of a nation, republic country, has given rights to its citizens. And what are these rights? Let's discuss them one by one. The first right which we have is equal before the law. All people, irrespective of their caste, creed, their position, social status, color, they are equal before law. Suppose there is the chief minister of any state and there is some other person who is a criminal. They both have done murder. So the law, they are equal before the law and they both will get the same punishment. It's not that this person is the chief minister of a state, so he should be getting only 1 month's prison or something like that. And the criminal, who is already a criminal, he would get 10 years in imprisonment. It's not like that. They both are equal before law, irrespective of their caste, creed, social status, money, or their position or their job. Right? Second, no one can be discriminated. We cannot discriminate any other person on the basis of the factors of discrimination, which we have discussed earlier. Like nobody, I can't discriminate anyone on the basis of color, religion, caste, gender, or education. Next, access to all public places. Beyond that, all the citizens of a republic country or a democratic country have the access. They can use the public places or public property. Suppose there is a mall. Every Indian, every citizen is allowed or permitted, have the right to go into that mall. Okay, I can't say, no, you are not well dressed, you have not worn clean clothes, so you cannot enter. I cannot say no to anybody, because the government of a country or the democratic country gives them a right to access all the public places like park, malls, shopping complexes, amusement parks, market, temples, and other places. Next, abolishment of untouchability. No person of a democratic country will be discriminated or will be said untouchable, or we cannot say anybody, he is not worthy of touching. Means we cannot say ye achhoot hai or something like this. He belongs to a lower caste, he belongs to a Dalit dynasty, so we cannot touch him. It is abolished. Isko khatam kiya gaya hai in Indian or democratic country. Okay, so these were the four basic rights which every democratic, which our democratic country offers us: the right of equality before the law, second, discrimination, no one can be discriminated, second, third, access to all public places, and fourth, abolishment of untouchability. Nobody will consider anyone as untouchable. So class, we have covered the right to equality section of our class, of our topic. Now fourth, role of Indian government, role of government to implement equality. What does our government do to ensure equality among the citizens or all the citizens? Hamari government kya karti? Sabse pehle hamari government ensures or implements law. Wo laws banati hai. If somebody discriminate or treats the other one unequally, then there is a law. He can be put, the person who is treated unequally can go to the law and he can complain. He can lodge an FIR. Okay? Our government ensures laws to protect the equality of every citizen. Second, government programs or schemes. Our government implements or have initiated some programs like the people, have you heard the RTE Act? If you talk, this is an example class, RTE, to ensure equality among the citizens of India. Hamari government ne kya kiya hai? RTE Act shuru kiya hai. Where people who belong to lower social status family or who don't earn that much as a rich person earns, unke children's ko our government allow them to study in well-reputed school. Bahut achhe school mein unko padhne ke liye hamari government ne laws banaye hue aur programs chalaye hue hain. Theek hai? They have the act or they have the right to study in a well-known school, and they are given the equal opportunities just like the other rich people of or rich children of India. To ensure the equality among the poor, the government has done this or initiated this scheme. Okay class, this is the role of our government. Beyond this, the government has also initiated a one more scheme, that is midday meal. operated schools or all the schools which are operated under the supervision of government, they are allowed to provide the lunch facility to all the students between the age of 6 years to 14 years. Means हर बच्चे को elementary school में up to 6 from 6 up to 14 years they will get their lunch in school only and that to a balanced diet and just to give them equal opportunity in school for studies. Earlier what happened, people went to school for free to get the education for free, but later on after the lunch period is on or when the lunch period happens, they went back to their home and did not come back for studies. So this thing not only helped the students, schools or the government to get more enrollments or more admissions in school, but it also kept the women's or the parents of those students who had to leave their work and come back to prepare the lunch for their children to work free-mindedly in their workplace. इसकी वजह से क्या हुआ, एक तो बच्चों को लंच और बैलेंस्ड न्यूट्रिशन डाइट मिली स्कूल में, प्लस वो पेरेंट्स जिनको अपना काम छोड़कर घर पे आना पड़ता था, स्कूल घर पर आना पड़ता था अपने बच्चों के लिए लंच बनाने के लिए, वो फ्री माइंडेड होके अपनी वर्क प्लेस पर अपना काम कर सकते थे. ठीक है चिल्ड्रन, एंड मिड डे मील, देयर इज अ पर्सन हु कुक्स द मिड डे मील. तो ये मिड डे मील बनाने के लिए उन औरतों को चूज किया गया जिनके साथ अनइक्वलिटी प्रैक्टिस की जाती थी इन द पास्ट, लाइक द दलित, सो कॉल्ड दलित. यहाँ पे मिड डे मील बनाने वाली जो भोजन माताएं होती है और द कुक हु आर एसोसिएटेड विद प्रिपेयरिंग मिड डे मील फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स, दे वर गिवन द चांसेस, दे वर गिवन द जॉब्स टू प्रिपेयर मिड डे मील फॉर द चिल्ड्रन. सो क्लास, दिस इज हाउ आवर गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू अबॉलिश inequality among the citizen of a country. Next, role of government we have discussed, class. Now the next thing, article 15. Article 15 is a law which ensures the equality of, which ensures the law, which is the law, it is a law which ensures the equality of every citizen of a state, and it has two main points. And what are these? Every people in India will be treated equally, and there will be no discrimination of any citizen on the basis of religion, color, caste, education or gender. Second, no citizen is restricted to access any public place. Means कोई भी public place है तो किसी भी citizen को हम वहाँ पे जाने से रोक नहीं सकते हैं. And the second thing, any public resource or amenity, we cannot prohibit him from using any public property. Suppose there is a water tank, we can't say you are not allowed to drink water from this water tank, because our Article 15 ensures the law of equality of every citizen of a country. Now this is done. There was a very famous movement called civil right movement. It happened or it took place in USA in year 1956. In 1956, earlier when the Africans were slave to Americans, they were treated unequally. Many whites, Africans kya hote, they are black in color, so they are also called as blacks, and the Americans, USA's, they were called whites because they were white in their skin tone. So earlier, before 1956, the people who were Africans, they were not treated equally as the whites were given the chances. And earlier, whenever they set off or they used to get free from their work and they drive back or they were using the public transport to go back to their places, the blacks, the Africans have to leave the seat for the whites and go to the back seats, or they had to stand in the bus. But later in 1901, a woman called, a woman whose name was Rosa Parks, she refused. She was tired of the day's job and she refused to leave the space of bus or leave her space, seat of the bus for a while. So she was the, basically the cause of civil rights movement, where it discriminated, it prohibited, it protected the laws or the equality of people on the basis of color and religion or the nation they belong to. Basically, the blacks were from Africa and they were slaves to the whites or the Americans. ठीक है, तो Americans. So this law, civil rights movement, it took place in 1956 after Rosa Parks incident, and it encouraged lot many Africans to stand or raise their voices against the discrimination based on color, and they also demanded the right to equality. And this happened after that, the civil right movement or civil right act was passed on, which ensured that every American and African, they will be given equal rights in every places. So class, beyond the government is passing or government has ensured or implemented a lot of laws to ensure the equality of people, there are still many places or still many people who don't follow this equality, right to equality, and they keep on discriminating the peoples on the basis of their colors, caste, creed and a lot of things. But these things are needed to be changed, and we have to understand that every citizen is equal before the law and he has got some basic rights. It is equality, abolishment of untouchability, equal before the law, equal to access, all are equal to access public properties, and the fourth one, they will not be discriminated. So we have to understand it, and wherever we see as a aware citizen of the country, we should tell them not to discriminate or not to do so. So class, this was it in the chapter. What you have to do at home is watch the video and do the given work. And class, if you have any problem, you can give a call between 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. during school hours and school days, and you can clear your doubts to your respective teacher. So class, this is it. Now we have completed the chapter. Just go through the video once again and do the given work. Thank you and have a good day.